Right. Wow, this is really weird feeling.
Wheels like this.
Flight deck.
Captain, time is secured for takeoff.
Alright, thank you. We're all good to go.
Good to go.
Alright, we need to actually prep the checklist. Want coffee again? What's the matter with you? You gotta stop doing that stuff.
Hi guys, welcome to Cockpit Chatter. Prepare kami ngayon umalis. Time check, 3:30. Kikitain na namin si Patrick Roa sa Alpha Aviation. So, see you there.
Hi! Good morning!
Alright guys, we're proceeding to the briefing room with the Capt. And David, before we head to the sim.
You know.
Oh, you know.
Welcome to the...
Hi, David.
Hello.
So can I record while we're briefing?
Yeah. Sure. Alright, so good morning, guys. Welcome to Alpha Aviation. Two things. So put value in training so I could treat it like a national airplane. The sim can also be used to show you things that what the aircraft would do in an extreme
condition.
Yeah, even at an extreme level, we can demonstrate normal law on an extreme level for you to see what the protection systems are like. Before any setup, I was coming here, sometimes my PowerPoint and instructor will show what they're going to do for the day. As you can see, here's an example of
the 320.
The 320 mock-up. So, the instructor will talk about what's going to happen, what to do, the flow, mostly flow oriented. For today, what I'm thinking is we'll do a normal cockpit preparation. So we'll review it now before we go in. But so you'll see how it's like to set up the aircraft. Also, when you get in the sim, armrest adjustment is very important, very vital. The concept of Airbus is that the arm is actually rested, the aircraft is flown by the wrist. You can fly the aircraft with just two fingers. Do not lift your elbow, do not move the whole arm group, okay? Because once this thing starts floating and you're going to be using the whole thing, you're over-controlling whether you're doing it wrong. There is a technique that I do. You will see the body, the flight controls can actually move here. You will see that. You can also use that as a reference.
You can move the armrest?
Yes. And that's a no-go item. If that thing is not working properly, that's a no-go. Also, the centering, the eyeball centering mechanism for your eye for your line of sight, that is also very important. Taxi. Taxiing is a little here on the sim. Not really about it. So, slow taxi from terminal 1 to runway 06.
Okay.
We'll do a normal takeoff and with radar vectors, and then we'll just do one touch and go. And then one full stop, the normal. But you get the feel how it's normally flying the Airbus on a visual approach. Afternoon, second landing, in post-op landing, freeze the sim, I'll reposition the aircraft to the threshold. Then I'll make the weather IMC, as you requested. And you'll do a takeoff and you're going to experience wind shear at about 100 feet. So you're going to start to feel the aircraft that are going to shake.
Windshear.
For the first time, it might be a little frightening. I'm not gonna lie, but it's fun. At least you'll get to see, you'll see how the speed is going all over the place. You might even get an overspeed or something. Then I'll give you guys a dual FMGC.
Oh wow.
So we're gonna lose, you're gonna lose both of your flight computers. Autopilot off, auto thrust off. Actually, the dual FMGC is one of the standard failures for your Capt.
Alright, we just lost your autopilot on the thrust off. Alright. The thrust lever is moved. We're actually going to move it there. We're actually keep it there because we're climbing.
Okay.
And we have a thrust lock, so we move the thrust off.
Remember, all of these things flew in 1987.
Yeah.
Right?
Play the CRT3.
1987.
Oh yeah.
And it has improved a bit. Alright, this thing, your phone is more computing power than this.
Yeah.
It's only probably what, 25 MB by now or something.
What should be your of auto thrust off for normal problems?
You'll see.
There is a threat vector, you know about.
Yeah.
But the threat vector is also technically your energy vector.
So that's the speed tape in the main vector?
Yeah, it's basically the trend vector. We'll demonstrate it to you later on. When you see, actually see that thing there, you can actually adjust the auto thrust. Once you're able to take the arrow out, that's about the speed you're in. It's called an energy vector. So I'm like, panel is actually controlling it right there.
Oh, wow.
It's basically on the speed tape. There's an arrow that goes up and down.
Yeah,
which is like, it basically gives a forecast of what your speed like in 10 seconds if you don't do anything and change. So it gives you like a prediction. So you'll still be able to navigate using raw data navigation. You can set the radio panel to switch over to nav mode. And you can tune the VORs.
On this panel, you see that thing? On
and so you press that button, so instead of the radios, it's going to be the frequency
of the nav.
Yeah, and the inbound core, so you can change that. And then when you set this, your APIS to Rose VOR, it'll come out, and here's the screen. So the third thing we'll do is engine V1 cut. So, which is the standard that happens in the airline, so you'll take off. You're gonna lose an engine, red at V1, so you can't reject. The only difference here is when you rotate, so first of all, you're gonna feel the V off, definitely. You're gonna go, so you got opposite rudder, right? Beta target is important. On a multi-engine aircraft, you probably slice the ball. Here you don't. The electronic system compensates it. Alright, remember, you have laser range gyros there and ADRs and everything. The algorithm is actually already placed in there. I had some guys who actually tried to split the ball. I said, well, I gotta split the ball. I said, yeah, you're a good multi-engine pilot. I fly with you in a piston or turboprop. But on this airplane, we actually modernized it a bit, you know, so keep the sailboat or the trapezoid, keep it flush. So that means your legs are gonna have to work. And when you use the rudder trim towards it, a good number is about 12 seconds plus or minus. The bird is where you want the airplane to be. So if you want the airplane to be straight and level, you put the bird right in between that. And the aircraft will be in straight and level flight. But it doesn't mean the aircraft, the pitch of the aircraft is zero.
Zero.
Regardless of the pitch required, it'll put you on the flight path you want to be. So you want to descend, let's say, 5 degrees down, you just push the bird into the 5 degree index, okay, on the ADI. By the time you put it in there, the aircraft will descend on a 5 degree angle on the way down, regardless of pitch. Pitch is the black little square there. Pitch can still be 1 degree above the horizon. Yes. It's a 5 degree flight path going down.
Most common mistakes that are being done for guys who fly the Airbus is like, they get the idea that they correlate the fly-by-wire system, the protection system, into like it's a game. They try to hack it. Do this, you know, before you land, you do a little, one more flick of that thing and it's gonna give you a really nice landing. Stuff like that, okay? That's the first thing that, you know, you should never catch on, you should never do. Because later on, when you move to other aircraft and you do those things, that could actually cost you. Another important thing is when you come into the landing. Remember I told you it was 30 feet? Even on the standard procedure, you know, you have the thrusting numbers here. Because the aircraft will perform as advertised. It will deliver based on the algorithm. Now when it comes to 30 feet, take the thrust out because you still have residual thrust, you have ground effect, you have all of those things that are already working. Take it out and start to begin your flare. Don't pull it back too much, just flare the aircraft. We'll talk you through the landing and how to correctly flare. And get the right pitch out and just wait. And just let the aircraft touch down.
Not too much. Keep it there.
100 above.
Set it there. Next level.
50, 40, to the minimum.
Another bad habit is once the main touches down, some guys, they actually let go of the joystick and the side stick. Just let it go to the nose slam up. Some captains do that, and they got it from, they said, oh, you know, we were taught this way, you know, the aircraft land and stuff. You won't, don't do that, land the nose. Okay, when you land the mains, land the nose of the aircraft.
Go, go, go! Reverse the airplane, please land the nose.
If you get into a crosswind situation and the upwind goes up there and picks up a wing, aside from the weather rate, by the time you correct and bring it there, put it in the airplane. Because like I said, even if it's fly-by-wire, it behaves just like any other aircraft.
Actually have
a chatter for destinations 1 or 9 at a time.